picture in the paper. I saw her on the television news last night. Her name is Rita Reutter. She's a 58-year-old widow and decided at 50 years of age, decided to go to college. 57, she had a bachelor's degree and decided to go to graduate school at Florida Technological University. And she's a grandmother of 14, and she's been headline news all over the country. Yesterday, you saw it compared with this morning. She has been elected that school's homecoming queen. No joke. Would you welcome Rita Reutter?
Welcome, how are you?
Is that the school pennant?
That's his.
In the trophy room, the gang of Florida Technological University. I think the people thought we were kidding, but the people who've seen the papers and saw the television news last night know that it's no joke, right?
That's right, it's no joke. I'm here.
Well, congratulations, first of all.
Yes, like they say, you know, and this is from me to you. There's a happy face and a sad face, and you can use that when, like when they come into your office and they take a look at that to see if you're happy or sad.
In other words, if you don't want to talk with people and they come in, you just give them...
Yeah, right.
Not a bad idea. That avoids a lot of conversation, doesn't it?
You may... And I would say to you that after all, you see, that's what I'm doing in graduate school.
And... Making these?
Yes.
No, I know what you do. You already have a job, don't you? I saw in the news that you were working right now as a bookkeeper, was it?
No, I'm just a little clerical, a graduation clerk, they call me.
Yeah. Phil, may I call you, Rita?
Be my guest.
Call me Johnny, please. I saw this on the news last night, and it's legitimate. You became the homecoming queen. Now, how did you decide to run for... Did somebody put you up to it? Did you just decide to do it on your own?
No. You see, I kind of... Well, in the first place, I'm a student senator.
Right.
See. And they were talking about the homecoming, you know, week and the things they were going to do and the contest that they were going to have. So the minute I heard contest, I said, hey, can anybody join? And they said, sure. So I said, how about it? What do I got to do? You know. So they said, well, you have to be backed by a student organization. I said, okay, I'll find you one. You know. So then what do I do after that? And they said, well, you have to get 250 students, 250 signatures. So then what I did...
To get you on the ballot, huh?
To get nominations, you see. So I said, A-okay. I got myself a student organization to back me, and I put out the arm on anybody I could see. And that's how I got over 300.
And you said you're running for homecoming queen.
And I went around with signs on bags and signs on my back and you name it.
Did you think you'd win?
No, but I was having a lot of fun.
I think it's a great idea. I'm so happy you won. What did the rest of the kids in college think?
Oh, they enjoyed it tremendously. They certainly did. I enjoyed it more as I went along because I knew they were enjoying it.
How many people did you run against?
Well, it started out to be 19 other girls besides me, and then it ended up 11 other girls besides me.
Now, obviously, as soon as people knew you were running, and they knew your age, and you were a grandmother, and you got your degree at 50, the newspapers must have come in quickly, and you...
Well, as quickly. It all started with one little blurb in the newspaper in the Sentinel Star in Orlando.
Right.
And all of a sudden, the roof caved in. You know, I was, everybody was hot to trot right after Rita Reutter.
Now, your name, Rita Reutter, I'm not going to do the obvious joke. I'm not going to do the obvious. The people must say about your name. You probably tired of Rita Reutter jokes by now?
Well, I'll tell you, I don't mind. I really don't. Because they had on one of the TV stations when they were giving the news, you know, and a couple of the fellows were saying, gee, just imagine if Rita Reutter decided to use Rita Reutter as their secretary, and when she picks up the phone, she says, Rita Reutter speaking.
Look, we're going to take a break here for a commercial. We're going to come back and talk a little more, okay? All right, we'll be right back. We'll be right back. And if you just joined us, we're talking with Rita Reutter, who is 58 and doesn't mind mentioning that you're 58 at all.
No.
Got your bachelor's degree at 50. Do you feel like some kind of a symbol for people In the 50s now that you won homecoming queen?
Yeah, I'm kind of like an older sex symbol, I would say, yes.
Hey, why not?
Yeah. Well, I figured that after all, just because you're 58 doesn't mean you gotta fall in a box, you know.
No way. No way. No way. Right on.
Everybody that sees me on the airplane, everything.
It's also relative. As I remember when you're 15 years old, somebody said, if they asked you, said, what is middle age? You'd say, well, I suppose you're 30 somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Then you get to be 21 and you say, what is middle age? You say, about 40.
Mm-hmm.
Then when you get to be 40, they say, what's middle age? Well, somewhere around 60, I guess. And you keep moving it up all the time. When you ran for homecoming queen, did you have a campaign slogan of any kind at all?
Oh, yeah. My campaign slogan on the bag that I carried was, you can have cutie pies anytime. You know, let's add a little pizzazz to this homecoming.
You can have a cutie anytime.
Mm-hmm.
Just get a little character in here.
That's right. I was the character.
What does your children think of you writing?
My kids loved it.
Did it?
And my grandchildren loved it. And the school loved it. In fact, everybody at Tom's Hideaway Lounge over there in Route 50 in Orlando.
What was this? Some lounge? Is that a hangout?
Yes.
Is that the local college hangout?
Right down off Alafaya Trail, you know, and they got a nice beaded screen, and that's where I saw myself on the Chancellor Brinkley show, and I actually saw Brinkley smile.
They even actually smiled?
Yeah, and that was the first time I had seen myself in full living color on TV.
What was the name of this place you mentioned? Is that the hangout where you...
Tom's Hideaway Lounge.
You go down and have a couple of beers there occasionally?
I'll just bend my elbow a little bit and have a little pizza and, you know, kind of mix it up.
Gotta have a tank once in a while. You live by yourself?
Yes, I do live by myself. Mm-hmm.
You ever thought you'd live with your children, or do you think that's a good idea?
No way.
No way?
No way. No.
That's interesting. Now, explain why.
I'll tell you. In the first place, of course, when you live with your children, everybody has their own ways of bringing up their kids, okay? And my favorite way is that if the kids don't behave themselves, a short shot to the head. See? Well, they don't go wrong with that.
I think Eric Fromm suggested that originally, yes. A quick, short, right to the head and get their attention first.
Yeah, right. Rearrange the brain a little.
None of that psychology, a little shot. So you think if you live there, you might start to do that?
You know, I'd have to hold myself in and I figured, hey, let's not get into a big hassle about it.
Yeah.
So, and the kids enjoy it anyhow.
That's super. What kind of courses are you taking, Holly?
Well, of course, I'm going for my master's in guidance and counseling, you see, but my bachelor, yeah.
You're going to guide them, all right. We're going to guide you.
Well, one way or the other,
that's
they're
going right.
to get launched.
Yeah, I think you got the direct approach.
I believe in the direct approach at all times, Johnny.
Yeah.
That's why my social life is, you know.
How is your social life? Do you date? I mean, you don't mind my asking.
If I can get my hands on somebody, I would, yeah.
Well, now, granted, most of the kids going to college are a little young for you, but...
But we have mature students, too.
Yeah.
Oh, certainly, yeah, but that isn't the problem, you see. Is what happens is that, you know, there aren't too many guys around my age, and when I sashay up, they sashay the other way.
Yeah.
So I try hard.
Yeah.
But I guess maybe,
You're not adverse to the possibility of
getting
remarried?
Well, you know, I guess when I flutter my eyelashes, it just doesn't work. That's all.
Yeah. Now that you're homecoming queen, you know, a lot of guys...
Well, you know another thing too, though, Johnny. You see, I probably have a problem. I really probably have a problem. And that is that I have a tendency to pinch. And...
You mean you're the pincher?
Yes.
Most women don't like that. They accuse men of pinching.
Well, I'm reversing a lot of things, you know.
Yeah.
And so consequently, when I pinch them, then they're afraid to give me their back.
Yeah.
You see? When they see me coming, then they head in other directions.
Yeah.
I'll tell you.
Where do you pinch them?
Oh, well, that's my secret. I can promise you, though, that it's not where it shows.
Okay, well, that's good.
Mm-hmm.
Now, do you belong to any clubs or anything like that?
Well, I do belong to a singles club, Young Heart,
well, that's good.
In Orlando. But they're kind of a nice, quiet group, and I'm not really that quiet. So it's kind of hard to be quiet, you see. Yeah. And it's a lot of ladies looking for a lot of gentlemen, and we're having a hard time.
Yeah.
Because gentlemen are not the kind to join, you know, clubs or something.
Staying around the bars and watching.
Yeah, yeah, you know, and of course the thing is this, that a guy who's around 55 or 58, he's not interested in a woman who's in the same age. He's looking for those chicks out there, see? And my feathers are a little bent right about now.
Doesn't seem quite fair, does it?
No, it doesn't. That I agree. No, because...
Suppose you were your age, Rita. You were a man. You were 58.
Uh-huh.
What would you be looking for?
Well, I suppose I'd be looking for vitality. But see, that's the problem. I got vitality. I got other things, too. Yeah.
You think they have too much of a preoccupation with just the physical sexual
attraction? Yes, yes. And after all, if you ever got a chance to know my mind, you know, I've got a wonderful mind. I just don't get a chance to show it.
No, I believe that. Well, there's still hope, though.
Yeah, I guess there is.
Why don't you hang around? Did you get to stay in California for a while?
I would love to stay, but I figure that my studies call me.
Do you have to go back to Florida?
I have a course that's about to blow my mind.
Yeah, what is it?
Research methods.
Research methods?
Oh, yeah.
Statistical data?
Oh, reams and reams of material. And you see, I have to keep my mind on my studies. And sometimes it wanders.
Yeah.
You know, and especially, well, you know, I'm having first troops looking at the nice athletic young men as they're going by. But they always manage to stay out of reach.
Yeah, well, they know about the...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, my reputation precedes me. Yeah.
Hey, it is great having you out here, really. I think it's so nice that at your age you ran for homecoming queen and you were elected. I think, you know, you make a lot of people happy in the country.
Well, if I may just have one quick flip and say, hey, Pat, Marge, Joan, and Kay, I hope you enjoyed it.
Hey, thanks for being with us, Rita. Hey, have a nice trip.